A United Nations convoy is delivering aid to a besieged Syrian district outside Damascus this morning. The food and medicine come after eastern Ghouta saw renewed attacks over the weekend from government forces. More than 600 people have reportedly been killed in the rebel-held area. That is one of many battlefronts across the fractured country. Seth Doane traveled to Afrin, Syria, and he's the first U.S. correspondent to reach the area since the start of a Turkish offensive. Seth, good morning.
Good morning. Just when you thought this war in Syria could not get any more complicated, well, here we are. We have come to Afrin because it is a new unfolding front in this conflict. We're surrounded by a number of people who have been displaced by the fighting, and the fighting here threatens to roll back progress in the war against ISIS.
The U.S.'s most effective ally in the battle against ISIS in Syria, the Kurdish YPG fighters, have turned their attention here. Afrin, a Syrian city of ethnic Kurds that had been an oasis of peace in this war, is now under attack by Turkey. The U.S. has been arming the Kurdish militia, but Turkey considers them terrorists and doesn't want an emboldened militia on their border. So Turkey launched this offensive in January with repeated airstrikes and shelling. But here's where it gets even more tricky. Since Afrin is in Syrian territory, President Bashar al-Assad has sent in fighters to back up the Kurds who've been living here. And those troops were welcomed like heroes. All of this means that President Assad, the man the U.S. accused of bombing civilians and carrying out chemical attacks on his own people, is now helping the very militia the U.S. has armed and continues to support. For CBS This Morning, Seth Doane, Afrin, Syria.
Boy, thank you very much, Seth.